Hello everyone, welcome again. Now in this session we will solve problems based on positive definite matrices, negative definite matrices, positive, semi-positive definite matrices and semi-negative definite matrices. You know, I have already covered all these concepts in separate 4 lectures. Please go through them. I will be providing the link of all the lectures in the description box of this lecture. To go ahead, move ahead with the problem, we need to understand the concepts thoroughly, first of all. Second thing, if you go through the previous year's question papers, you will find that every year, almost every year, one or two problems are definitely asked on these topics, which are positive definite matrices, negative definite matrices and all the categories which are discussed now. So please go through the link, all the links one by one and understand them thoroughly, as one question will be definitely cracked if you understand them nicely. Now the question is, which I am going to discuss now, is taken from December 2012 of 3 marks and CSIR NET examination mathematics paper. Let A, B, C be positive real numbers such that some relationship is given here, b square plus c square less than a less than 1. Consider 3 by 3 matrix A, the quantity is given here. Then the eigenvalues of A are all negative, both positive and negative, all positive can be complex. Now, let's have a look on the matrix. Can we see anything special in this matrix? Yes, elements here and here are same. This element same with this element and this element goes same with this element. Real entries, all real entries. So this is only possible when the matrix is a symmetric matrix. Still we can prove it. Let's find out A transpose. Row 1 will be written as column 1. Row 2 will be written as column 2. And row 3 will be written as column 3. Just match A transpose and A matrix, are these same? Yes. It means what? A is a symmetric matrix. For any symmetric matrix, eigenvalues cannot be complex. So this option anyways goes wrong. And the problem is of 3 marks, so only one option is going to be correct. Now, next is, whenever we have any symmetric matrix and we talk about the signs, positive, negative, signs of eigenvalues, then the problem is definitely based on positive definite, negative definite, etc. type of matrices. So we just have to identify whether it is positive definite, negative definite or what. So for this we will take help of leading principle minus first of all. As I already discussed, you need to go through the theory part first to understand the problem which I am going to discuss. Otherwise, it is difficult to understand what I am going to explain here. So let's it's a square matrix, it's a symmetric matrix, and then we can proceed to check whether it is positive definite, negative definite or semi-positive definite, semi-positive definite or semi-negative definite or indefinite type of matrix. Now, once we understand which type of matrix it is, we can quickly talk about the eigenvalue sign. So for this, let's check the sign of leading principal minor of order 1, leading principal minor of order 2 and leading principal minor of order 3. If we just take this element matrix and find the determinant of this, suppose this is A1, this is plus 1, which is greater than 0, or we can say positive. So what I am trying to find is leading principal minus sign. leading principal minus sine. So first we have got is plus 1, which is a positive quantity, positive greater than 0. Another leading principal minor would be 1BBA. Let's call it matrix having elements 1BBA. So determinant of this will be 2. How can we tell about the sine of a minus b square? For this, some relationship is already given in the problem itself. So let's take the relationship from there and discuss about the sine. So we are given with b square plus c square is less than 1, less than a. Or we can write a is greater than b square plus c square. That's the same thing. Fine. Now a minus b square. So b square can be taken this side. Still, a minus b square will remain greater than c square. So we can write that this is nothing but greater than c square. Now c is a positive quantity and after that we are squaring. So it is definitely a positive quantity or greater than 0. So leading principal minor of order 2 is also a positive quantity, for which we took the help of the relation which is given in the problem. Now we will be talking about the determinant of A itself. That's the leading principal minor of order. We'll keep the relation here. So leading principal minor of order 3 will be determinant of A itself. Let's expand it through first row and will be A minus 0, B only seems, and C minus AC. It's correct. Further, A minus B square minus AC square. Now, A minus B square is already proved to be greater than C square. If we understand inequality well, we can definitely write that this entire quantity, if we replace this by C square, will definitely as A minus B square is greater than C square. So, if we replace it with C square, this will definitely become greater than C square minus AC square. Hope inequality properties we are very much familiar with. So, this can be written like this. Further, if I solve it further, C square will be taken common. And this will be 1 minus a. Now again we talk about the sine of c square, that's positive. 1 minus a, it's given here a is less than 1. So if a is less than 1, it means 1 is greater than a. Any quantity which is less than a, if we subtract, will be a positive quantity. Or we can think like this, 1 minus a minus a will, subtracting a both the sides, 1 minus a will also be positive. And this is positive quantity. This also becomes positive. So ultimately we are going to get a positive quantity. So determinant a is also positive. So all the leading principal minors positive. So whenever for any symmetric matrix all the leading principal minors have positive signs, it means we can declare that the given matrix is a positive definite matrix. For theory and concept part, please go through the previous lectures. So, reading this part now. For any symmetric matrix, leading principal minus greater than 0 implies that A is positive definite matrix. And for any positive definite matrix, once it is known that the matrix is declared as positive definite matrix, all the eigenvalues will be strictly greater than 0. Greater than 0. Strictly positive. So further it implies that A has all positive eigenvalues. So this way you will find that almost every year one question based on these concepts are regularly asked. And the weightage is also good, 3 marks or 4.75 marks. So the option A has all positive eigenvalues. All negative, wrong. Both positive and negative, wrong. All positive, correct. So the final answer would be B is the correct option, and we got the solution, 3 marks, 1 solution correct. So keep watching, we'll be back with more problems, easy explanation. Please share and subscribe it. Thank you very much.